So this boy is, nah, I'm something, so I went slowly there. As soon as I went there, Baba was calm, he put my her hand over my head, come on, bacha, bacha. Oh, child, come and sit here, nearer better. I was a little bit from inside, some ego came to my So everybody's scared, Baba's telling me. So I saw my friends, come on, you also. They were afraid. So one came near, but afraid to approach Baba. No, bad. Come on. Baba, putting a hand on me, after a few minutes, he used to abuse some other person. Facing otherwise, if they are busy. As soon as he turned the face, how much of it? So every crowd was looking at. How this boy is went there sitting in a Bhavajan on the chair, caught, and Bhavajan doesn't say anything to him. And she's abusing her. He won't allow anybody to come near her. I'm sent for a few minutes. I asked my friends, come on here. So they were afraid. One came near, but not the others too. He said, no, I'm not, I won't go come there. To hear all the abuse, I'm not going. Then after a few minutes, I had to leave. Bhavajan, please, I want to. Ah, boy, here, see, just be gone. I came from there. I said, you're afraid, don't come. Because you've got love for God, he won't be. So if you haven't got any love, Bhavajan will abuse you. So I loved her and I went there. See, she called me, she asked me, see. You have no love, you didn't come. This thing. But as he's mad and all these things, the abusing, God has abuses, as you don't know. In this abuse is a blessing. Yeah, I told him. Baba is to tell us. So this is the Bhavajan's story. And once Bhavajan, we used to go in the evening. So at that time, I was grown up after a few years back. Every evening I used to go to Bhavajan. Why? So at that time.
How old were you about
that? At that time. First, that time I was 14 or 13, 14, 15. First in the Sima. But afterwards, on the age of 17 or 18, about 17. I went to Bhavajan and I used to go every night. So what those Bhavajan, they used to go Bhavajan, they used to come there, she used to offer tea. But what the Mandali knew, those people knew, near her, they used to count how many people are sitting. Because Bhavajan never took tea alone. If you offer tea, you have to give all those sitting here. If they have 2 days, you have to give all the 2 days, then last you will take. This was routine, and everybody knew. So they used to count the head and go and bring the tea. Tea shop was the opposite. They go to bring the tea. The tea shop order, only ordered it, because it brings so much tea. So they used to bring the tea cup. And the man who offered, he'll come up and give the Baba's hand. Baba used to take, give you someone. Call someone, nearby, from this will come on. Suppose you are 3-4 players sitting here, she won't give you. He call someone from there. So I was always late. I used to sit behind. So as soon as she saw, I used to get. I used to get. I had my ankle before this war. So one day what happened? Bhavajan gave, instead of giving me tea, once gave me tea, but after tea, she gave me 2 bidi. Bidi smoke, and you know, in Parsi, Zoroastrian, we don't smoke. Now, let's go. But being from my childhood, I was little bit also on my mother's side. My mother's side. Mother, Baba's mother, they're very Orthodox.
Orthodox.
So smoking, we were taught not to smoke. So Bhajan gave me. So I knew, sir, baby can't smoke, what to do? Now I can't give to anybody, can't throw it away. And Bhajan's gift, what to do? I came home. I came home, I was staying with my auntie because I lost my mother. And I was staying with my auntie. Baba's the younger, eldest brother, Jamsid. I was staying with him. And Jamsid, Bhajan gave me this thing. What to do? I don't know. I can't smoke. He says, smoke, no? Smoke. What? We are girls and we can't smoke. At that time, I had no idea. I won't smoke. I must smoke. And do one thing, he said. Open that pity and take the tobacco out, chew it, give it a mouth, and spit it out. Give that. Just like it is. I took that tobacco, took out the tobacco. But he said, at night before you go to bed, do this thing, and when you get here, give me something, wash your face, and go to bed. The night before going to bed, I broke that two pieces, put tobacco. So something, you go inside, I started to give you. I should wash my face, clean my face, go to bed. Next day, Bhajan gave. In my heart, I was praying, Bhajan, don't give me something else. When I went there, sitting there, I was praying inside, Baba, please, don't give, Bhajan, please, don't give me bathing today. Same thing, call me from the, come here, child, take this.
Bidi,
sir. Bidi, two bidi. So, I came home. Jim says, again, Bhajan gave me two bidi. Same, go on. Same thing I did. Then, the third time, when I said, now, Bhajan, too much, huh? But the third time, she gave me tea or something. The one time, she removed, she used to wear so many rings. Rings. On all the fingers, you will find all the rings. A cheap though. So once you remove the rings and put it in my hand.
She removed the ring and put it in your hand?
From my finger. I got it with me. Long ago now. It will go to pieces now. Because once the pieces, then I made solder it. I get to the second time, so other place. I used to wear all the time. Bathing or anything, I never used to remove from my finger. Because Bhajan put it, I never used to remove. But it took a piece, cheap one, it gone worse. And I kept it somewhere. I said, now, Bhajan thing, I must keep it. Because I wear so many times. Everyone used to say, so cheap. What is this cheap thing? I said, what costly thing? You don't know costly. I won't tell you. I never used to tell anybody what is this. Thank you. I remember this Bhajan. And sometimes he used to catch her back. Baba used to catch her back for all together at night. From midnight,
Baba used to
scratch her back. From Baba. She used to put like this. All together, from midnight to early morning. Because at midnight, everybody is to go away. And Baba was alone. Baba is to scratch. See, like, because he never used to take bath. But we never got sting or anything from our body. No, it's not. So pure. So sometimes he used to ask me also.
Ah, really? Yeah. Scratch your back. This is when you're about 17, huh? 17, 18?
The scratching back, yes. 16, 17.
What relation
did she have with Pendu? Tajun Sabri, she used to live in Nagpur, Tajun Maharaj. He was in Nagpur. She was from North India, Baluchistan. Bawaja. She was from Afghan or something. She was very good family, from big family, princess family. This family wanted to marry her. She doesn't want to marry. And she was very beautiful also. She ran away from her. And she came somewhere north, south side. She was Afghan side. And some Punjab or somewhere she came. And there, after a long time, when she was old, some military people, those were Punjab military, Indian military, there was British rule, there was British army, but the Indian troops. So those Indian Punjabi, they were not, they used to go to, but then she began to say, that, I'm God, and this thing, that thing. They didn't believe. They say, you see, this God, all these things. So say they buried there. Oh, body, the two of them, dug their well, they buried her body. You don't know this. And what happened, same regiment was transferred after a few months, something. They were transferred to Pune. And they saw the buried, night they buried away. You don't know this. But. And when they came to Pune, when they were passing, parading, going, they saw under a tree, Bhavaya was singing. The same woman in there, who was saying, I am a god and this thing, we buried her. See, they were in uniform, military, they passed away. They came to bury, all of them get together and they spoke, what is this? The woman we buried there, and she's here now. How did it happen? We were at the last moment we were there, we know that. But she never asked, how this is it? The men, they said, what she said, it was all right. In the evening, they all they came. Begged the pardon. I'm sorry. This is story what we heard. Far story, I don't know about this story.
What is the relation to
Tajun Baba? Tajun Baba is separate. See, he was in India from being. He was in Nagpur. And she was not Indian. She was not Indian. She was not from India. She was Afghanistan.
Did she know Tajun Baba?
No. No contact. The Maharaj, the Bhavaja, no contact.
No contact?
No, Bhavaja and Maharaj, no contact. Internally they might be able. But outside,
No contact.
No contact. Nayan Maharaj. Nayan Maharaj near Pune. About few miles, about 20, 30, 40 miles from Pune, the Nayan Maharaj was living. But they had no contact with each other. Internally, they must be one of you can't say, if you don't know anything about that. But outside, no contact. Only Upasya Maharaj got contact with Sai Baba. God realization through Sai Baba. At that moment, his contact, then after then he came few miles away from Sai Baba. He established the ashram. After Sai Baba dropped his body, he established the ashram. Upasya Maharaj.
What were Baba John's habits? I mean, did she just stay in that one place all the time? She must have had a piddle, she must have had all these things. Where did she go?
She was going somewhere. You know, we are not staying all the time. A few hours used to sit. But she never took a bath. They had no home. First, she used to go in the evening in the city. But then she left and stayed all the time there. And there, she was sitting on the ground. There was one water meter, municipality water tape, the meter was there, and there was cover, tree's cover was there. On that she was sitting. And then Baba made a platform, wooden platform. Baba burn one mattress first. Next, they will find the mattress gone. Someone pitched away. Beginning, no one knew about her. They will pinch his anything. Anybody used to give something, then they will go and find there is nothing there. Either she used to give it away or somebody used to pinch it away. You see, all open, you know, in rain, monsoon, winter, summer, all the time.
Would she get sick? Would she catch cold? What would happen?
Never. All the time. No smell, you know, because no taking bath or anything. No stink or anything. Nice hair, girl, nice face, round face, beautiful face. I met Pastor Maharaj, met Bhavajan, met Jasai, Nan Maharaj. I met all these three. I miss Sai Baba.
Miss Sai Baba.
He left body in 1918. My mother wanted to go to him. My mother.
Did your mother know Mera's mother? Did your mother know Mera?
Mera's
mother?
No. That time, my mother died very early. Before Baba stepped down, 1918. My mother died in 1918. I was old, about 15 years old, 1918. At that time, Baba didn't establish the ashram or anything. Although Baba used to come and tell everything to, because what happened, my Baba, my mother were in life, the spiritual life. And Baba used to come and tell everything to my mother. Auntie. She used to come to auntie. My mother was auntie to Mera Baba. So she used to come and tell. Because his mother, Baba's mother, didn't like what Baba used to do. Why he left school, why he left college, he got mad or something in the beginning. Because they thought he's gone mad. One thing, he loses his job. Why he lost college and this thing, and studying, not doing job. She was after him all, do something. So he went to please her. Once he went to Calcutta, his uncle, as a, in a dramatic company, as a manager, assistant manager. He stayed for 1 month, 2 months, came back, and mother was pleased, my son is gone. Then he went to Gujarat as a teacher, school teacher. He worked there for 1 or 2 months. So my son is gone there. To please her mother, he used to do this thing. Then tried to shop open. Everything to it. At that time, his mother, he has gone mad. When he used to go to Bhavajan, once he went to the fight with Bhavajan, what you have done to my son? What is gone mad? Bhavajan, talking, she left his parents. Then my mother, on the contrary, encouraged Baba. So that came to know his mother came to know that my mother. So she ordered Baba not to go to your auntie, not to step in his house, in her house. Because, yeah, you see, she's spoiling my son. And whenever Baba, in the beginning, Baba used to go to Saya, Upas Maharaj, no one knew except my mother. He used to come and tell my, I'm going there. So my mother gave my Deva and this thing, that thing, anything. And what Baba used to tell to his mother, I'm going to see my brother. His elder brother, Jamsed, was in Bombay.
So that's what he told his mother, huh?
Yeah, I'm going to visit my brother. Instead of going there, he used to go to Upaswara in the beginning. And then afterwards, he came to her. Afterwards, she also went to Upaswara. Upaswara told her, you don't know your son, who is he? He will shake the world, you know. You were very lucky one, this thing. Because at that time, I was also there. We also went. We were small. With the mother and I, we went Baba to us there. We went there. And then Baba Maharaj told her, you don't know what the child is. So my mother was taking it all the time, and Baba was there. And when my mother stay, my mother has asthma, very chronic asthma. And at that time, when in 1918, there was a big influenza in India. World War, First World War finished, there was a big influenza epidemic. So many people died. So at that time, I got influenza myself. And my mother thought he will die. So in our Zoroastrian beginning, now everything is gone. In Zoroastrian beginning, when the woman gets menstruation, they keep aloof. They don't move in the house, they don't cook, they don't touch anything. Separate bed, separate other things. After menstruation period finished, they take bath. Then they touch everyone, everything. We never supposed to. Orthodox people are not one of them. So at that time, my mother also, my mother, Baba's mother also. So I was sick. My mother was sitting at the roof. So she was very anxious. When I go and see, and she thought all people dying every day. She used to hear so many people dying. Every 50, 40 people dying in Pune. Pune was empty now. So many people ran away, some of them. So my mother was anxious. As soon as her period was over, she took cold bath. Although she has a customer, she took cold bath and to be near me. She came. And I was all right, and she got well sick. I was all right. And she was sick. The Baba used to visit, come every day used to come, Baba used to come and talk with her. And say, fine. He told her, he said, Baba, when are you going to take me to Upas Maharaj? You don't take me to Sai Baba, now take me to Upas Maharaj. When are you going to take me?
She used to ask Baba.
Yes. Don't worry, I'll take. The one man was very serious ill. One day she brought something from Maharaj. He had something. She gave to her. He put it with his own hand in her mouth. Take this. And don't worry, you, in the morning you'll be all right. Don't worry. In the morning she'll have a body. Same just like nymphs. In the morning you'll be all right. Auntie, don't worry. She will say, you Gujarati Masi, don't worry. Masmidanti, Mitrana, Masu, don't worry, you'll be all right. Take this, in the morning you'll be all right, don't worry, then we'll chalk out the plan. In the morning, it's no more. Because I remember I was standing near him, near bedside, and they were talking, I was listening. I remember that. I said, don't worry, take this from Maharaj, take this, you'll be all right tomorrow morning. And the second time I heard about nuns.
Yes.
Don't worry, tomorrow morning you'll be all right. Completely all right. Completely was all right. He got to Papa. That's true now, too much now. Yeah, what happened in 1938? Baba was in Mahamudra Panchani. And he said, I don't know, he called me or sent me a letter and said, I want to build that water tank, the reservoir water tank, build over a building, one floor. And with that, some tower like thing. You know the tower? Only Baba, some of the tower from outside, from long distance, you can see and building. So, Western woman, want to stay, there was no room for Western room woman. So Elizabeth, Noreen and all the people, they had to stay there. So build this thing. And build that tomb. The tomb place was there where in 1927, Baba dig that ground and there was wall. Same place, you know, wall and tin shed was there. Tin shed was there, roof. Tin roof was there. And one window only, you know, one door, front door. And Mao was saying, in 1927, and that time I remember when Baba was there in 1927, he stayed there for long. He used to sleep down and over the pit, there used to be a big platform, wooden platform was there, and in the daytime he used to see it. And from the window, he used to talk to Mandali or boys or anyone. We used to go near him, from the window he used to speak there. Speak without bore or anything. And at night time he used to go to inside and sleep there. And every day, I used to give him bath. I used to save. I got him saved also. I once saved and kept it there. Was packet. He's a miser fellow. So I used to stay there and keep it. And give him bath there. Then collect water in the bucket and throw it out. And Baba sit on the platform there. I remove all the water and everything. And then Baba ordered me in 1938 to build that nice stone and hold that nice tomb. Dome, everything. That's all right. Then at that time it was the rainy season again. And to take the material up on the hill from that gate. At that time here, the wire was there, the railway line. Then it removed after Second World War. When we used to take our material from there, from the railway line gateway, you know, the gate. The car goes here the other way. So the material, to take material in the rainy season is a very different job. Still, Baba gave me some time. And every time Baba used to come to see how, first he used to say in Mamsa, and some material we couldn't get here, we ordered from Bombay. Some iron thing, girder and all the thing. So that took time to come from there. For 1 month power like this. And when they came, then Baba came and stayed in Dagbunga in Banaga with whom. And every day Baba used to visit. Come on, friends, soon, come on, quick, Pendu, come on. And every time he used to visit, he used to give some order. One room here, something room, the Kakua was staying. There also, last moment, after 1 month, I built one room here, we'll run a hospital here. And that was better than the hospital. We'll do that. Come on, build this thing, build that thing. Every time he used to come and new thing crop up. So the day was going passing and so many works to finish. For 2 months and Pazi now used to go come up. Because there was Kali Mama, my name Kali Mama Lava. He was the engineer. After building engineer, he was retired. Old man. So because he was too old, so for a tower, he designed me a tower, designed the strike, how to take it. He was designing. I had no idea. But I used to bring the material, do the job, and, but he used to give me idea, drawing and all these things. But by then he went like this, because both the idea was separate. You know? They used to call. So by then I'm not coming, I won't come there. I said, don't worry, don't fight and let the boy, I will marry the boy, or the old man. Because every old man, every day used to change plan. Every 2 or 3 days, oh, I'm in mistake, come on. So we used to get down, break down again. So father did like that. So father, no, the old man, crack old man. I said, no, I will marry him because Baba's giving me a job and I will do that. And I finished with that. But don't worry, what I did, because dome was here, mission here is no good. So we got in from Bombay. Narima's uncle, Narima's another Chinese uncle, Narima's Chandra Dino, pardon me.
Chandra?
Chandra. Chinese brother, but never uncle. So he was an engineer, drafting. So he, we called him also. This, you want to build this tomb outside? You got, and the four minas, you know, the four signs, the cross and the crease and all these four sort of tomb, he built it from Bombay. They did concrete, a very solid thing. You can't, two people can't lift it. Very strong thing, heavy thing. Cement concrete, he prepared that. I said, please get me that and get me some mason from Bombay who can prepare. So he brought me. And that time, Pazi went with him. I said, I will do that because I can work with the
mason.
No, with that engineer, Chinese, I will do with him. All right. So he worked with him. The tool was the mason and all the Pazi was looking. I said, Pazi, you look at. I will marry this old man. And what happened? The work was before work. See, there is so much lot, and very few days left. But we have less than 5 or 6 days left. And well, there was work, so much work to do. The staircase going up, there was not done so much. The tower job was there, a little bit left. And Baba said, how can you finish the job? No, please, I will try. So what happened? So Baba asked us, and there was a military contact, a big contract. At that one time, big contract was going on. A big military contract was there. So Sarv said, Baba, was a big contract. It was huge material, so many men, and carpet, all. It was thing like this. Baba said, go on, break him. So now a few days left, and it is very slow, and you won't be able to finish this thing. I want to go before that time. So Sarv brought there. One day I saw Baba came with Yash. In another car, I saw Sarv or someone. I had no idea who they are. They talk, and he asked me, come on, tell me what you do. I said, this work is left, this work is left, this work is left, this is to finish, this is to be. I told him and went to with Baba. And so then they discussed. They left. And Baba left. Next day Baba came back. And then the boss, I asked Yash, who are they? Yes, Tijukaya. I knew the name, the big contract, Tijukaya company. Why? I will tell you afterwards. Then I knew Baba wanted to give to them. The next day when Baba came, he called me. Pendu give me. Because that man said it won't be able to finish in time. He said more time. 15 days more. 15 days more extra time. Then 8 days and 15 days more. Then we came able to finish. It's impossible to finish in short time. Baba called me. And I don't know what they had to talk. Baba said, oh, call me and ask me. You want to? Baba called me and asked me, will you be able to finish? Baba, do one thing. What? Please don't come here daily. Every time he used to come, he used to go over some new job. If you want this thing done, I will do it. I will try my best. And I will see that Baba says anything happen. If half done, I will ask you to get down, I will come and stay with you. I don't mind, I will stay there. And I will, if there is no staircase, I will do manage. But I am finished, I am angry. But you will finish, otherwise I will come. You are that day, everyone should be get down. I said, all right, Baba, I will manage. But no, I want one thing. You don't step here. Come on that day. Because I know, bro, every time you come, you give me something. You say, I won't give, but still you will give. Please, you won't. I will try. And you know, night and day, what I did, night and day, without sleep.
Nine or 10 days without sleep?
No. Last 3 or 4 days.
3 or 4 days.
Without sleep. Because I, extra man, I apply my extra man, everything. But the place was bad. The tower and the staircase and all these, we can't apply more. very good. So for 3 or 4 nights, no, so I used to, whole day I was on the field, on the wheel. My, I used to go to take lunch, or my lunch was coming up, my food and tea and everything. And double shift, the men. And I opened a tea shop there. Just to give the tea to the workers, myself, come on, and night also. Day and night, big lamp, it's a lamp, is there. Petromax lamp, and we used to feed day and night. And the last moment, what happened? The small library, you know? Library roof now this day. But before, there were like the black red tiles. Red tiles were there. Red tiles were finished. And that's what left the room. The library room was without tiles. About to midnight, I sent a truck down. Go and remove from the Mandali's roof. I was short of the tiles. I said, go and remove the Mandali. They were big bang. Sent 3 or 4 boys and man, they removed and brought the night out. Peace. You know, about 3 or 4 in the morning, everybody ready.
What did this all include, huh? This included the tomb?
No, tomb was in the tower, the staircase, and place in the
hospital.
But few rooms or something were left. And this was a library, you know, library room. So, in the early morning, everything finished. I've cleaned the place also, full of flowers, like few flowers there, and keep the work party up. Give the all the, I locked everything, and give the key to party. Come, party, get up. Take his key. And if Baba come in the morning, he will come. He said, I will come on that day. I mean, you have to come now. I have done everything, and he has key. When Baba comes, give, I'm going to sleep, and don't wake me up till I get up. I won't, now I sleep now for 3-4 days. Don't wake me up for food or anything. One separate room, I went there to sleep. An old building. I ran to sleep. In the morning, Baba came. When they were, they have to pass the village, you know, that gateway. From there, they saw the tower, they stopped the car there. They had everything, everyone, my Puma, Muira, and everybody. They saw the towers there, everything. At last, finished, we went. Went inside. Top, everything went. Every stack is ready, everything is ready, room is ready, everything is ready. Also, priest immediately came down. He gave the key and woman with that. Before he went all around, see everything. He came down immediately down. And to see me, he had no idea that I was. So he came about this door. I was sleeping in this room. He came near the door and he was telling Padre, where's Pendu? And I heard that, in sleep I heard that, Padre, Pendu is sleeping here. I thought, Baba, we got up on bed and came up. Baba caught me and embraced it tight. Baba was kissing. What are you doing? I'm sleeping, Baba. The Padre told me, last 3-4 days not sleeping, not coming down here, Baba. Then what to do? When he asked me, I want to sleep, don't wake me up. I said, now go to sleep. After you leave out. And Baba said that for a minute, and he said, now go to sleep. And I have no money to disturb him. But then, after 2 or 3 days, they were the housewarming, you know? What do you call housewarming?
Yes.
The ceremony was done, all the village was called. And prasad was distributed, there were lectures. There were Chinese give lectures, something about praising, about how they were. Then compound wall was finished, everything. Baba Prabhu asked Vishnu to bring the garlands. Garlands, order garlands, and bring it. And I had no idea. Then Baba called me. We were sitting there, near the tomb. There was a platform, that platform is removed now. And they told our leaders all ready in the city, Baba city, Mandi was sitting down, the whole village was sitting, and Baba gardened me. That garden I have kept with me. The garden and the ring and Baba saved.
Well, what did he say when he garlanded you?
He
said, nice job, or?
He embraced me, well done, I'm very happy with you, what you've done. And when Source came to know, then he sent his to me out of work. His sorrow said, and that, that contract went to move 50 years more than what. Then he had done it immediately for that Baba. Because I know, when Baba wants anything, he himself does. We are medium. But if you put your full heart in it, full, if you do it, 100%, put your heart and work it, you will see the work is done. But if you say, Baba said, Baba's work, Baba will do it, and if you half-heartedly do it, you won't do. Won't be able to do, although Baba said. But Baba said, for that, you must put 100% in your heart. If you do it 100%, you will succeed 100%. Because Baba said, and Baba has done it through you. But not me done it. It was Baba done it. I think that way, because I put my whole heart, I did it, my best, that to see that Baba's word must not go. Baba see that it will finish. Those Kanda Kunda, Baba did this thing. And that time also, in 1954, I said, Baba wants this meeting on this day, must be. And that was done. Anyhow, I got everything. In the last moment, I used to get. The very last moment, I got. And table chair was the last moment. I was disappointed. I was moving here and there. But because Baba helped me in this way. Because I was sincere in my work. I 100% put my heart and did it. And Baba helped me. And I know, if you Baba wants anything, he does through you. But you have to put sincerely 100% in your heart and do it. And you see, there's a must be. Goodbye. Thank you. Ta-ta.